The family of Hannah Clark has spoken out tonight about the act of violence that killed their daughter and her three children and horrified a nation. In a powerful interview, they reveal what happened the night before the attack and how hard Hannah fought to protect her children.
That you find your strength in crying.
From shock and grief to anger, a quickly arranged protest in Brisbane this afternoon attracted only a few hundred people, but they spoke on behalf of a nation.
We are making a stand against domestic and family violence. It is absolutely everywhere and no one is safe.
The family of Hannah, Trey, Layana and Aaliyah today also somehow found their voice, and it was powerful.
The night before he killed them, he was on the phone to the children crying, and when she hung up, or the children hung up, she said to me, "Mum, I feel so bad for him."
This was Rowan Baxter's tactic, play the victim. But in truth, he was an abusive, controlling partner.
It was always Rowan's way or the highway.
Hannah turned to her family and friends.
She didn't believe that she was in a DV relationship. It hadn't even crossed her mind because, as she said to me, her words, "He didn't hit me."
Instead, he subjected her to psychological torture and sexual abuse.
She wasn't to have sex with him, then that would mean that he would punish not only her but also the children.
Last December, Hannah had had enough and moved out. She was protected by a restraining order, but she still feared Baxter would kill her. Her last Instagram post was one of defiance. "I'm a strong woman. I don't sit around feeling sorry for myself, nor will I ever let anyone mistreat me again."
She was so brave.
Yeah.
Emotions which have taken their toll. The lead investigator in a media briefing yesterday set off a social media storm.
Is this an issue of a woman suffering significant domestic violence and her and her children perishing at the hands of the husband? Or is this an instance of a husband being driven too far?
Domestic violence campaigners condemn the comments as victim-blaming at its worst. Today, the Queensland Police Commissioner offered an apology while the officer was stood down from the investigation.
He is distraught and gutted because of the way he explained it and then construed.
A mistake. There may be more, as inquiries will focus on whether more could have been done to protect a mother and her three children.
She did everything, sacrificed everything for them.
Damien Ryan, Nine News.